It's like 12 o'clock, almost 12 o'clock, and all morning I've just been sipping on that lemon water that you saw and cleaning all my snow stuff. So I just had to unpack everything, put my sleeping bag away and all that stuff. So that's taking me hours this morning. My skin is freaking terrible. Whenever I go to the snow, my skin breaks out, but more so now than last season, because when I went to the snow, I actually ran out of my hormone herbs, like the herbs that balance my hormones and all of my vitamins. So I just stopped taking them all together and my skin went ballistic. It's so bad right now. Even though I ate healthy at the snow, I just ate carbs and like high sugar stuff, which is healthy but bad for my hormones and bad for my skin. And I had to wear a balaclava over my face because of the wind and the cold, so that just congested my pores and my skin is just like, what is this? That's like a, oh my, I can't even. Anyway, so today I am going off to the gym. I was gonna go fasted, but I didn't go early enough in the day. I think if I go to the gym now, I'm gonna start working out and be hungry. So I'm gonna go make a small light meal before I hit the gym. First, I'm going to the gym in 5 days because I've been at the snow. I'm not too worried about it because I was snowboarding every day, which is a workout, let me tell you. One of my favorite light meals to have, I'm going to have just some protein bread. I'm obsessed with bread. I've always been obsessed with toast. So when I found this company, I was like, oh, so excited. If you want to use my discount code, go for it. They also have muffin mixtures and pancake mixture, and they're coming out with something new and exciting, which I'll show you guys in the next vlog. But I'm just gonna have two of these.
It's like 2 o'clock or something now. I wouldn't know the exact time because my phone just died. It was on like 70% and it just keeps dying. It keeps giving me that sign, like that battery sign, and telling me to plug it into power. Frickin' Apple. I didn't have the best workout. Whenever I film my workouts, they're not very intense because I'm moving the camera around and stuff. But look, you guys are my priority. You're welcome. So I need to go to Miranda, which is like a suburb up from my gym, and pick up my herbs for my skin because, like I said, it's breaking out. So it is detrimental that I go and pick up my hormone supplements. I really didn't do much at the gym. I just sort of like moved the camera around and did a few little light body weight exercises. Even when I was just doing like jump squats, my legs were burning. I think it's from snowboarding because my legs are constantly engaged. Any exercise today really burnt my legs, so I really couldn't be bothered to go hardcore.
I'm home now from swinging by my naturopath to get my supplements. So I got my hormone tonic, which is just like a bunch of Chinese herbs mixed together. So that helps balance my hormones. This used to be called Seraphos. Basically, I take this in the morning to help send appropriate signals to my brain to produce ideal cortisol levels, because I have high cortisol levels, and glucose support to help me absorb carbs and help my insulin resistance. So this helps not spike my blood sugar levels. So I got these three, and hopefully once I get back on these for a week or two, my skin will go back to normal, because right now it's disgusting. Some people want me to be heads or tails. I say no way, try again another day. I should be happy, not tipping the scales. I just won't play, letting my life get away. Outside, it is the perfect excuse to make my healthy hot chocolate, which I have literally every single day. Today I'm doing 6 grams of raw cacao powder, a crap load of stevia because I love it sweet. I'm gonna do 100 mils of almond milk. My secret ingredient is a fat. This is the ingredient that keeps you full, and it's like the key to this recipe. I either use coconut cream or coconut oil. Coconut oil really helps my skin. It's an antibacterial and good for digestion and helping you go to the bathroom. So I'm just going to add a teaspoon of this. I think it's around 5 grams. And then the rest with hot water. And yes, I like to make them massive. I'm a person who loves food and I love sweet things. It's like people who chew on gum. This is like my gum. It just keeps me, what's the word, Mum?
Satiated?
Yeah, it just ties me over between meals. So I like to make it as big as my head. I'm about to make some dinner and I'm just craving vegetables. So while I was cutting this up, I also was snacking on some of this like Asian medley that my parents were having. So that was like my pre-dinner snack, just vegetables. I've cut up 125 grams of butternut pumpkin, 266 grams of zucchini. That's just like a whole large zucchini, 40 grams of an onion, and 47 grams of mushrooms. I'm just gonna stir fry all of that in maybe some tamari or something like that. Make it like an Asian stir fry. I can never ever find the right words, and there's no way this is real life. There's no telling you're the right girl, so I can only say that it feels right. It feels right, it feels right. Yeah, I can only say that it feels right. It feels right, it feels right. Yeah, I can only say that it feels right. Hungry, but I just feel like making one of these. I've seen people make like protein mug cakes. So here I'm just using some Tropica Pump protein in chocolate. So I've just got 25 grams of the protein in there, half a teaspoon of some baking powder, a crack of some Himalayan pink salt, a little dash of some almond milk, I did add a bit of water to that, but I've decided I'm going to add a whole egg into it because, number one, I need some more fats in my diet today, and I think it's going to help it make it more fluffy and rise better. I'm also going to add a little bit more stevia because I do like my dessert super sweet. I'm happy with my mixture. I just gave it a sneaky taste test and it tastes good, but I am going to transfer it into a bigger bowl. All right, let's check it. Ooh, looks good. It's been in there for about, I don't know, 40 seconds. It's still a bit gooey, so I reckon we could put it in for another 30 seconds or so.
Look how good that looks. It's like a full-on cake. First taste of my mug cake. What I'm going to do is get some of my Walden Farms maple syrup and sprinkle that on top. This isn't super healthy, but it's super yummy. And it's low carb, and I'm trying to get my skin good again and trying to get lean and blah, blah, blah. Whoops, that's a lot. So much better. It needs to be like sort of liquefied a little bit and have something wet and gooey, but
update on that dessert though. Oh, best dessert I've made in a long time. Definitely put the Himalayan pink salt on there because it made it taste like salted caramel. So the Walden Farms pancake syrup and the salt mixed together, amazing. I'm gonna put the macros of that cake here. If you're gluten-free, dairy-free, paleo, you can have that dessert and it tastes amazing. So that recipe really works with all of my dietary requirements. And before I go, I just want to say a massive, massive thank you to all your comments from my last video. I read every single one of them. I'm so sorry I can't reply to all of them because I just don't have enough time. But reading them seriously made my whole week. It just made me feel so loved and supported. And I really, really appreciate everyone who takes the time to comment. And the things that you said were so lovely and empowering. And when you guys respond like that to those videos, it just makes me open up more and just shows me that you guys like to see the real, raw me. Not that I ever hide anything from you guys or I'm not real and raw, but I guess that was more of my personal life, and I appreciate that you guys were so nice and caring about that vlog and about my issues. I appreciate all of you for following me and supporting my channel. But I will see you in my next video. Thank you again. Mwah.